decades, the Backstreet Boys have sold more than 100 million records, making them the biggest selling boy band in the world following their successful UK tour a couple of weeks ago. The boys popped into the studio for a chat.
Yes, the rumours are true. Backstreet's back. Get comfy.
Yeah, they're back. Welcome, AJ, Nick, Howie and Brian. Welcome, guys.
Hello.
How are you?
That was very good, actually. You were singing along to your own stuff there, your own clips.
We try to sound like those guys singing on the record.
Nicky, yeah, they're really good. So welcome back. Welcome back to the country. You've been on the road. How have we been looking after you?
Great.
Had a good little run here.
And the new album, This Is Us, and this is kind of, you've gone back to that sort of original sound, that kind of sort of dance, pop, harmonies, what you were really, really best at. Why did you decide to do that? Why did you decide to go back to that?
We just felt it was the what people know the best of the Backstreet Boys. I mean, when we took a little bit of break, maybe about, 6 years ago, and we had like a year and a half off that we were, you know, getting the sound together and, you know, coming back with the new album, Never Gone. We were kind of experimenting and we kind of went in this pop rock direction, which after we made the record and took it to the stage, we kind of realized it's not what people are used to seeing the Backstreet Boys. Even though we're like, it's so funny because we're like chameleons and you can give us a country record and we'll sing the heck out of that. We'll sing a rock record, we'll sing, you know, whatever. But we realized that, you know, the kind of group that we are, the entertaining type of a group, to go on stage, we really needed the pop R&B music.
It's, I suppose, the problem is being able to do that's whatever style of music you feel comfortable with. There would be a restriction, but the record company would say, "Oh, guys, you've got to stick to the sound that we know. The fans, you've got to be very careful how far you go because the fans will expect a certain sound from you."
Yes, no.
I mean, yes and no. I think the label has allowed us to grow. I mean, we started this almost 17 years ago, and a group like ourselves doesn't really have a shelf life, we call it, for more than two or three records, and we just released the seventh CD. So I think it's just what we try to do is good quality music is timeless. Mm. And if you can continue to make good quality music, then you can be around as long as you want to be. It doesn't matter if it's country or pop or dance or Euro R&B. It doesn't matter. But I think we come from all different backgrounds. So when you take all those different music styles of what we listen to and you stir it all together, that's what that staple sound is. Of like, where have I heard that before?
We had Bon Jovi in here a few days ago, sitting exactly where you're sitting, and they were saying, John was saying that obviously, you know, any band who has been together for that amount of time, you know, you do go through the ups and the downs, and you guys are exactly the same. I mean, you said you took the break, but in actual fact, there was a time when relations did break down really between you.
It's funny, when we speak about Bon Jovi all the time as being someone to emulate, you know, career-wise, because we've seen them go through the hard times, and, you know, but, I mean, that's just a part of it, and, you know, it's uncharted territory for the Backstreet Boys, because, I mean, I don't know, they've been together probably 20-something years, you know.
Yeah, at least.
And, you know, we've been together 17 years, you know, so we're continuing, and we don't know what's ahead. All that we know is that we're enjoying what we're doing. We love making music. We love going on stage and entertaining.
Do you feel better equipped to be in the industry now that you're a bit older, now that you've been around the block a bit and seen it all once before? Do you feel in just a much better place now?
I think so. I feel like we're definitely like seasoned veterans, believe it or not, now.
Yeah.
You know, we've seen a lot. We've grown a lot in the business. I think, you know, from when we first started to where we are now, I mean, we've not only grown up as, you know, adults now in the business, but we've really come to learn what the business is all about. And I think we've even had a chance to, you know, even with the break at one point, to step back and really realize what we had and what we want and how, you know, we appreciate
the fans. So no more
fans
falling off the rails then? We're all right, we got security all around us.
You know, all is said and done, and we have each other. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, that's really what's kind of kept the steering of the ship for so many years.
So what happened when, I mean, I'm assuming that this is right, that you were in New York promoting the album, got swine flu? Is this true?
Yeah, I stopped steering the ship. fell in.
Is it true?
It was true.
Is it true that there's a reason for going here with this question now, because you said that's okay. Don't wait. Wash your hands quickly. So you were all on your own. You say these guys, you know, they're with me all the time, but you were suffering from swine flu and left on your own.
Yes, they left me for California.
Yes.
And well, they didn't want to be around.
It was for the best. It was for the better of the group. You know, if I had to take it for
the
team, that's what I was doing. So I was stuck in the hotel room.
How come you got it and nobody else did?
You know, it's amazing that happened, because we were on a plane from Tokyo to New York, and it hit me like a ton of bricks the same day. Like, I had no symptoms or anything, and I broke out with a fever on the flight. And then the next thing you know, my joints were killing me. And I thought, well, maybe it was too much, you know, air pressure, flying all the time. We were doing heavy, heavy promotion. And come to find out, the doctor tested me there at the hotel, and I had swine flu. So they had all called me, and they were like, I'm not coming to your room.
We love you. We support you.
The room service people were leaving the room, leaving it outside the door.
Just push the trolley. Yeah,
he's like a leper, for crying out loud.
Irony of the situation was, about a month prior to that, we were in Europe, and Brian had we got off the plane. He was taking this tea tree oil, and he was like dropping it in everybody's mouth. Come here, come here, come here. Put this on your tongue. And I'm like, what is this? He's like, I am not getting swine flu at all. And he was the only one that got it.
And you know what? These guys, all three of these cats, they burn the candle at both ends, and I'm the one that goes and rests, and then I get knocked on my butt.
Because we built up our immune systems.
Whatever,
we don't mind getting around people.
I'm like, whatever.
Guys, thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.
Great,
good luck with
the tour,
and next year as well.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you.
They were terrific, weren't they?
Lovely boys.
For an exclusive look at what the guys got up to behind the scenes, go to itv.com/thismorning. If you're a fan, you'll love that.
Right, we are back for the second part of our Makeup Masterclass.